Hello, beautiful Virgo. Welcome into the Gifted Hermit. I hope you're doing so well. My name is Lena. I reside in London, UK, and I'm also a Virgo, baby. I hope you're doing so well. Yeah, if you're new to the channel, a very warm welcome. Shout out to my returning subs. I appreciate you. Let's get into this. This is going to be a general love reading. It may or may not resonate with you. If you find something does, please go ahead and smash the thumbs button. I really do appreciate it. Who is thinking about Virgo? Who's currently thinking about Virgo? Oh, anytime I get the King of Swords, it could be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. It doesn't have to be those signs. It's somebody that's... in like, can you ever get that feeling when somebody thinks they know it all? Like, nobody knows it all. We don't stop learning till the day we die. Very clever, intellectual, Mr. or Mrs. type of energy. Okay, it could be that there's somebody here that's willing to work through things. I feel like somebody wants to speak up. This person that's thinking about you wants to talk to you. There's something they want to get off their chest. And then maybe writing it down or thinking about what they're going to say to you. I feel like it's going to be an offer, or they're going to express their feelings in some way. We will clarify the energies. Let's clarify it now. Let's talk about this Nine of Cups. Why is the Nine of Cups here? Somebody may want to have a conversation with you, okay, with regards to the way things turned out or the way things currently are. Remember, this is timeless energy. Why is the Nine of Cups here? But I definitely feel, yeah, somebody wants to have a conversation with you. Maybe to express how you make them happy. They're willing to put in some sort of sacrifice. It could be a Capricorn here for some of you guys. It doesn't have to be. But again, I definitely feel there is a conversation on the horizon where somebody is going to be expressing exactly what they think and exactly how they feel. Okay? Let's move on to the two wants, Virgo. Eight of Wands. Could be somebody that you met online, somebody that is at a distance from you, whoever it is that wants you again. There's an energy here of communication. Four of Cups. Five of Wands. Maybe there's been some sort of disagreements, whoever it is that wants you, not seeing eye to eye. There's a very detached energy here with the Four of Cups, like you're not bothered, or it can talk about boredom. It can definitely talk about detachment, and it could be from a water sign, someone maybe that's a bit younger than you. It could be a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. But I see, yeah, maybe perhaps an ending here, or somebody hurting. There has been some drama. Who is it that wants Virgo? Let's clarify this Four of Cups and why. Maybe somebody is detached. Why is the Four of Cups here? Ace of Wands. You want passion, Virgo. You want passion. Especially those that may have their Leo and Venus, like I have that. So again, I'm a Virgo. But I feel like you may have detached yourself, or detaching yourself from something because you want more passion. You want to be, and don't take this as a bad thing, but like center of attention. You want the attention that you're not perhaps getting right now. And I feel like a lot of you would prefer to be alone than to be with somebody where they're just not fitting the bill. They're not making you feel as good as you know you felt before, or you'd like to feel. Okay, maybe you've expressed that as well. Let's talk about this Knight of Cups. Why is the Knight of Cups here? The Knight of Cups, Three of Swords here. The Knight of Cups could be hurting right now. You could have hurt them. Maybe not necessarily. Yeah, there's an unexpected energy here. There's an uncertain energy. This Knight of Cups for some of you guys is feeling quite uncertain right now. Maybe thinking that you've got somebody else. Listen, this could be transferable energy. And yeah, okay, so this Knight of Cups is really stuck in their head about something here that happened unexpectedly. It could be a conversation, it could be there's definitely an uncertainty with how they feel right now. And somebody's ego or somebody's feelings have been hurt here. Who truly loves Virgo? Who truly loves Virgo? Queen of Pentacles. I'd like to suggest that that's you truly loving you. I would also like to suggest that that is somebody that does truly love you. They love your grace, your caring energy, your generosity, your grounded energy, your energy to not live in your excuses, you know. Very achieved, very independent, very courageous, very strong, very graceful. It could be a Leo that truly loves you. The month of July or August may have some sort of significance there. Something about patience. You know, a lot of you guys may be just in that patient energy and you're happy to just carry on as things are. And, you know, what's meant to come for you will come to you, right? Who truly loves Virgo? Five of Pentacles, somebody that you perhaps broke up with. Again, we still have this Ten of Swords on the bottom of the deck. So I'll definitely like to clarify why the Five of Pentacles is here. Seven of Pentacles, there's somebody here evaluating here. There's somebody that is, it's almost like they're able to get into depression. They're able to get in their mind. There's somebody here evaluating something that has been said or they're going to say. This is somebody that is devastated about a connection. It could be you. It could be your person. Okay? There's somebody here not wanting to let go of negative emotions. Why is the Five of Pentacles here? Let's get one more card. Knight of Pentacles. But you may find that this person is persistent. Interestingly, the King of Swords on the bottom of the deck. There is somebody here that's quite clever. They can withdraw as well. This type of person can become very cold, very logical. You know, there may have been emotion, but they can easily withdraw that emotion. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Right, so let's see what's coming towards you in love. What is coming towards Virgos in love? What's coming towards Virgos in love? A fresh start, perhaps, and an Aquarius for some of you guys. Optimism, taking a risk, a new beginning. Yeah, something about a new beginning. What's coming towards Virgo in love? Taking the risk, taking a leap of faith. King of Wands, could be a fire sign. It could be somebody that's very alpha male. Somebody that's quite a character for some of you guys. What's coming towards Virgo in love? Six of Pentacles. A positive mindset here. Could be a 50-50 type of love, giving and receiving. Tell me more about this King of Wands. Nine of Wands, Nine of Cups. There's an alpha here, male or female. They're persistent. They're manifesting you. They know what it is that they want. And they want you. Very interesting. They want their Virgo. Interesting indeed. I want to pull you out an oracle message. What's the oracle message for this love reading for Virgo? Romance. So whether you know it or not, romance is on the agenda here. No need to worry. Wait. And I did say something about patience. You know, not making any sudden movements or decisions, Virgo. Oracle message for Virgo. What's the oracle message? Wow. Cupid, we send great waves of love into your heart and mind, awakening your love for life itself. Your clear decision to accept and enjoy romance has triggered this reawakening. Allow yourself to spontaneously celebrate love in all its glorious aspects. Ooh, Cupid is about to strike. whether you know it or not. Cupid is in your energy, Virgo. So I'm going to leave it there. Please remember to smash the thumbs button if you found that it resonated in any way. I friggin' love you guys. Thank you for the continued support. Remember, you can book me for a personal. Just get in touch. Follow me on socials. Catch me for live tarot. From one Virgo to another, be kind to others, as I always say. But most importantly, be kind to you and the gifted. We'll catch you on the rebound. Mwah.